Let's check in. Colin Cowherd, running feud with Baker Mayfield without question, talks about why his perception of Baker Mayfield's market has shrunk.
So there's a report today that NFL league executives are, quote, shocked that Baker Mayfield is just hanging out there without a team. I don't know why anybody would be shocked. He costs $19 million a year, almost. He's got a little bit of a toxic personality, and he had a bunch of injuries at the end of the year. So all of this was incredibly predictable. We said when the Browns went and got Deshaun Watson, they're upgrading at quarterback. Seattle is the only place that fits. But I also think Baker Mayfield made a mistake, and it's a mistake some have made, not many. Most quarterbacks that are great are boring. Joe Montana, Tom Brady, when they were playing, were into football. They're good-looking guys, but, I mean, Brady only recently started doing national commercials. Andrew Luck is boring. Russell Wilson, sort of boring. Matt Stafford, sort of boring. Most of the great quarterbacks were. Peyton Manning, again, got really funny after he played. But you have to be totally committed, and you have to be a serious person. Jameis Winston was never serious. Cam was into Cam. Johnny Manziel into Johnny Manziel. And when Baker Mayfield did 20 commercials and magazine covers before he'd ever done anything, he sent a message. Money and personality matters to me.
Quincy, Colin's not taking a victory lap. He is taking a victory tour on his feud with Baker Mayfield. Aaron Rodgers did the discount double check, so you can find guys that have done that and guys that haven't. What side do you want?
If you get 2 + 2 = 4, but like the way you get there is wrong, do you still get credit for being right? Right? Like, this is why they make you show how he got to this conclusion is completely wrong. Like, even then, he said Peyton Manning didn't get funny until after he retired. Does he forget that Peyton Manning hosted SNL when he was the quarterback of the Colts the year he won the Super Bowl?
Yeah.
Like, where's the selective memory about when quarterbacks are allowed to show personality? No. You can be fun. You can be all of those things and still be a quarterback. But what you have to be at the end of the day is understand when it's a business and when it's not, right? When you have to just, hey, for the best interest of everybody, I should not be out here releasing letters and you know, talking about I want a trade request and talking to ESPN. And by the way, this was a quote from ESPN during this whole situation. Like, he said this to somebody on ESPN, credited about how he thinks that he can't come back before they traded for Deshaun Watson, right? So when you do that, you make yourself seem unreasonable, right? Sam Darnold was on a podcast the other day, and Sam Darnold was asked about, hey, what do you think about the Panthers if they draft the quarterback at 6? And he's like, hey, it's out of my control. I'm just going to do what I can and grind and hopefully I'll get an opportunity there. But if I don't, I'll work hard to get an opportunity elsewhere. That's all you got to say. I'm an idiot in a chair, and I know that's all you got to say. You don't have to mean it. Nobody got to believe that you mean it, but that's just all you got to say. What you don't need to do is release a thank you letter that, look, I know his fans are going to defend it, right? Baker fans have defended this to death. Oh, yeah, this and that. But it was not a smart move because there was a real lot of why and just overt passive aggressiveness in releasing that when he released it, right? If we're not gonna be ignorant to context, that definitely was there. And then the trade request thing, the kicking and screaming. It's just like, man, he's not good enough to deal with these problems. And then you're asking somebody to trade for it, right? That's the issue, right? You're asking me to put my butt on the line to trade for this guy who's throwing his other GM and coach under the bus right now. That's why he's not getting moved. It's not rocket science to figure out why. It's not because he has commercials. I promise you, the commercials have nothing to do with why he stunk on the field in 2021 and why he is hard to move right now. The tape has something to do with it and him leaking stuff out to the media during the 2021 season. Oh, that has something to do with it. But the progressive commercials, that's one of the few positives that teams are looking at with Baker Mayfield, because he was pretty good in them commercials, right? Like, ain't nothing to be mad about with that. See, this is where the Baker Mayfield mania goes wild, right? Like, people don't like him for reasons that I'm like, this is not why you shouldn't like him. There are other reasons why you should not like him as a football player. The commercials, I am past the point of getting mad at a football player for daring to get a commercial on his free time. Oh, my goodness. He's not playing football 24/7? Yeah, quick, get the commercial. I don't care. Like, I've never understood that side of NFL fandom that like wants all of their football players to do nothing but rely on football for income when it's like literally the most unreliable way to earn a living because you can get hurt and then your career is over. Yeah, if you want to do some media on the side, everything else like commercials, do what you got to do. I would never hate on that. But that's not why Baker Mayfield can't get traded. He can't get traded because, you know, he's been a jerk this whole time, right? And he ain't been playing well. And don't nobody want to play for – nobody wants to trade for a jerk that also is not playing well. Like, you got to be Aaron Rodgers to get away with all this.
Yeah, I agree wholeheartedly. If you can make endorsement money, more power.